In practice, it is not possible to produce an image using the signal from free induction decay, and for several reasons, the signal emitted from an echo is used. The two most common methods use a spin echo and gradient echo. This animation illustrates the process of creating a signal using spin echo. The top two panels again show an array of 7x7 dipoles in the laboratory frame, as viewed down along the main magnetic axis. The two panels differ in their mechanism of relaxation. The top left uses spin-spin dephasing, whereas the top right uses inhomogeneity dephasing. Each panel has its own timelines displayed below. The top timelines display the RF power, which is the same as before except for one addition. There is the previously seen 90-degree pulse, which initially flips the dipole around the x-axis into the xy plane, but it is now followed by an 180-degree pulse around the y-axis. Loosely, this new 180-degree flip has the effect of reversing the spins, such that any previous spins that were advanced are now retarded by the same amount, and vice versa. At this point, all the spins appear dephased and there is little signal. Then something magical happens. A little time after the 180-degree pulse, the spins realign and again process in synchrony just like they did in the beginning, and a strong signal is detected. After this, the signal again decays as before. The reappearance of rephased spins is called an echo. The analogy commonly used to describe this phenomenon is that of a marathon, where all of the runners are released at the start line, each running at a different but constant speed. The faster runners move to the front of the pack, while the slower runners remain at the back of the pack. If at a certain time a whistle is blown and all of the runners were directed to turn around and run back toward the start line, then all the runners should arrive at the start line at the same time. This is due to the fact that the fast runners would catch up to the slower runners. Back to this animation. This process only works if the spins were advanced due to magnetic field inhomogeneities and not due to spin-spin coupling. That is why we would display two different decay mechanisms, spin-spin dephasing on the left side and inhomogeneity dephasing on the right side. The right side shows that the signal lost due to inhomogeneities is recovered shortly after a 180-degree pulse, as shown by the lower sinusoidal curve. This demonstrates that with a spin echo technique, a second peak of signal can be created, which eliminates the effects of field inhomogeneity. The left side is identical, except for the mechanism of dephasing. Notice that after the 180-degree reversal pulse is administered, an echo is not formed, and a second pulse is not obtained. This is due to the fact that dephasing due to spin exchange is not recoverable. In the marathon, for example, this could be due to runners running at different speeds, based on who is running next to them. Because the adjacent person is continuously changing, the effects of that person are fleeting and cannot be simply reversed.